ACTV receives state arts funding support through a grant from the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts, a state agency. Funded by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the National Endowment for the Arts, a federal agency.
We on?
Yeah.
Oh, there we are. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Berks Community Television. It is May 10th, and as a matter of fact, Sam's parents' anniversary is today, the 30th anniversary. So happy anniversary out there. This is the Acoustic Roadshow. Now, I know some of you are out there scratching your head thinking, what the heck are we doing on Tuesday night at 7 o'clock? Well, here's the story. The Royals won their division, and they were televised live last Monday night, and that's why we got moved to this night. So anyway, we're going to all get home a little earlier. If you haven't seen the Acoustic Roadshow before, for crying out loud, don't touch that remote, because you don't want to miss this show. We got a great guest for you lined up this evening, and we're gonna meet someone new, and then of course you get to look at somebody old like me. That's just the way it happens, isn't it? So we're on from 7 to 8 tonight, which is kind of a different deal, and we've got some things to tell you about, some places we're going to be, and some places our guest is going to be. So right now, I'm just going to kick off a quick song here. Tell you what, we're gonna break from the norm here. Instead of me doing my opening song, we're going to do a song and send it out to a lady named Jenny. Is that right? And this is going to be our duo here. Okay?
Okay,
here we go. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jenny. Happy birthday to you. All right, beautiful. All right, now, tell you what, make sure you move up on that microphone a little bit. I don't know exactly how all good right. That's picking up. But we were just sitting here talking, and I asked what the date was, and she said, Sam said it was the 10th, and she said, well, it's my mom's birthday. So that's to this young lady's mom. Mm-hmm. And I'll tell you what, I'm just going to introduce you right now, and we're going to get started.
Sure.
And I'd like all you folks to clap real loud so we can hear you all the way in the studio here. And this young lady's name is Naelee Rae. And she is an original singer-songwriter, and she comes from down around the Boyertown area.
That's right.
And anyway, what do you say you do a song to start, and what are you going to do for us to open up?
I'm going to start with a song that I wrote called You and Me Tonight.
You and Me Tonight. Okay, I can't wait to hear this. Miss Naelee Rae.
All right.
Been dragging on, baby, counting all the hours till the sun goes down. And getting all these crazy looks lately, whole lot of talk's been going around. And it's okay, it's alright, I get to see you tonight. Yes, I do. Got laying me somewhere and breathing all that country. Hold my head in the dark. Talk for hours, but nothing much. Time slows down, we're in a rush. I'll watch you. Still, my heart will just forget about tomorrow. It's you and me tonight. It feels this right, and we're not doing it for them anyway. No, I never heard from a little while. My heart's not gonna change. We'll seek out late and meet somewhere, and breathing all that country. Hold my hand in the dark. So I promise, but nothing much. Time slows down, we're in a rush. I'll watch you. In my heart, we'll just forget about tomorrow. It's you and me tonight. sit by the window waiting for a time when I can meet you underneath those stars and have you be all mine. We'll sneak out late and meet somewhere and breathe in all that country, hold my hand in the dark. Surprised by nothing, my charm slows down. We're in a rush, I'll watch you. Still, my heart will just forget about tomorrow. It's you and me tonight.
All right. Great song. Now, is that something original?
Yes, it is.
Is it?
Yep. I recorded that down in Nashville going on 3 years ago now.
3 years ago.
Yes. That's right.
Okay. Now, I know it's not proper to ask a lady her age, but you're still in your teens?
I am. Okay. Yes.
All right. That's all I said.
I'm 19. I'll be 20 in August.
You'll be 20 in August.
Mm-hmm.
So you recorded that 3 years ago at
16.
Yeah, I'm not real good at math.
That's okay.
I have to take off my shoes to count up to 20. So anyway, that's a great song.
Thank you.
And you have some CDs with you, and we'll talk about them in just a little bit.
All right.
So, Naelee, you're an original singer-songwriter, and how long have you actually been playing now?
Well, I've been playing guitar and writing songs since I was 14, singing since I was 10, but
yeah,
I started playing and writing when I was 14.
And I understand you've got a somebody that coaches you with your singing. Is that right?
Yes, my dad does, actually.
Your
he
dad?
Has since the beginning.
Okay.
Yep.
Well, he's done
great.
A good job. You
Thank
sing real
you.
Good.
Thank you, so much.
You got a great voice. And I know you've been, we were talking a little bit with your folks, and you've been around some places.
I have, yeah.
I understand that you played the Apollo.
I did. Yeah, that was one of my first real big performances when I was 10. The Apollo
That was
Theater.
When you were 10?
That was when I was
okay,
10.
Okay, all right.
Yeah, we stood in line, and it was a really cold morning, and I auditioned, and I got to be the star of Tomorrow.
Wow.
Which was an honor.
Yeah, that got to be exciting.
It really was.
And here you are 9 years later, and you're still working on it, huh?
That's right, yep.
And how about some of the other places they were telling me that you played?
Well, I got the chance to perform at Madison Square Garden.
Wow, because, that's big.
Yeah, that was incredible. It was a sold-out crowd, and that was when I was 12. So this was before I was writing songs, but so I did other people's, you know, I did covers.
Sure.
But it was still incredible.
Sure.
It was amazing.
All right. Well, what are you going to do? How about doing another song for us?
Yeah, sure. Well, speaking of covers, I think I'll do one now. This is one of my favorites. It's by Bruce Springsteen.
Loose Bedspring, huh?
Bruce Springsteen. That's what I like to call him.
Yeah, I got you. Well, yeah. That's his name. We just used to call him Loose Bedspring, that's all.
Oh. I won't ask why.
Huh? Well, it's just kind of a play on words,
yeah,
that's all.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah, I like old Bruce. So, anyway, we'll go ahead and cut into that.
Sure, okay. So this is Dancing in the Dark.
Okay.
I get up in the evening and I ain't got nothing to say. I come home in the morning, I go to bed feeling the same way. I ain't nothing but tired. I'm just tired and boring myself. Hey, baby, I could use just a little help. Can't start a fire. Can't start a fire without a spark. This gun's for hire. Even if we're just dancing in the dark. Messages keep getting clearer. Radio's on and I'm moving around the place. I check my look in the mirror. Wanna change my clothes, my hair, my face. Man, I ain't getting nowhere. Just living in a dumb black. This is something happened somewhere. Baby, I just know that there is. You can't start a fire. Can't start a fire without a spark. This gun's for hire. Even if we're dancing in the dark. You sit around getting older. There's a joke somewhere, it's on me. I'll shake this world on my shoulders. Come on, baby, the laugh's on me. Stay on the streets of this town. They'll be carving you up alright. They say you gotta stay hungry. Hey baby, I'm just about starving tonight. I'm dying for some action. Sick of sitting around here trying to write this book. I need a little reaction. Come on baby, give me just one look. You can't start a fire. Can't start a fire without a spark. This gun's for hire. Even if we're dancing in the dark. Can't start a fire. Worrying about your little world falling apart. This gun's for hire. Even if we're dancing in the dark. You can't start a fire. Sitting around crying over a broken heart. This gun's for hire. Even if we're just dancing in the dark. Even if we're just dancing in the dark.
All right, very nice.
Thank you.
All right. Well, now there's a few things, by the way, you probably took notice. I kind of snuck this sign behind us right here. If we can get that center camera maybe to shoot in there. Could we do that? Could we? There might be a little bit of a glare on that. Should I hold that thing front?
Hold it.
Straight up and down. Something like that there. There we go. All right. We're going to waiting for the Sam here to. Oh, man. Look at that. You zoomed right in on that puppy. Huh? All right, now you're zooming. There we go. You know what? We're going to get this out front here and do this like this here so you can read it right proper. That's Muhlenberg River Fest. If you take notice, that says August 27th and 28th, and that is at the Jim Dietrich Park, out in Muhlenberg Park, at Riverview Park. And you can go to that website there, www.muhlenbergtownship.com, and find out more information about that. Reason I brought that sign along is because of this young lady right here aside of me. She is she's going to be performing out there.
That's
August 28th.
Yes, I will. I'll actually be performing twice that day.
Twice mm-hmm. that day, right down along the river.
Yep.
On the acoustic stage. So I wanted to take care of that little business, and we've got some other things coming up here I want to tell you about in just a little bit. How about grabbing them CDs? Let's talk about them
sure.
CDs. And Sam, I'm going to ask you to get up on a close-up here for me. Okay, you want to do that with that camera you're at? Okay. Now, which one's your first here? We'll talk about the first
this
one.
This is my first one.
This is your first one? Okay. And this is, let's see here, we got to get that baby sponge just right there. We'll talk about this. And this is, what is the title of this CD?
This is a self-titled one.
Self-titled, Naelee Rae.
Yes.
And this was done in Nashville when you were 16?
16, that's
okay.
right.
Okay. And this is there any originals on this? Or
they're
this?
All originals.
These are all originals.
Yes.
Okay, great.
In fact, the first song that I did is on there, You and Me Tonight.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And Sam, if we could please, same place. There we go. There you are walking away. This one was looking at you, and that's the other side of you, and that's called High Five.
Yep.
And when was this done?
That was done last April.
Last April?
So it's been almost a year.
So you have
past a year.
I got to hold that steadier than that. So you have two CDs available.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if someone, the folks at home, would like to have these CDs,
yes.
how would they go about contacting you, either for maybe to hire you at something event that they're doing, or for your CDs? How would they do that?
Yeah, well, the best place to contact me is directly off of my website, which is naeleerae.com. And you spell that Naeleerae.
Okay.
And you can get singles off of there. You can get the physical copies of the CDs, or you could contact for any other questions regarding music you can do on there as
okay.
well.
Okay. That's great. All righty. Well, now, by the way, folks at home, this is Tuesday night, May 10th. If you'd like to call in the studio here, you can. This is a live show. Studio number here is 610-378-0426. If you have any questions about the Acoustic Roadshow, or if you have any questions for Miss Naelee Rae, we'd love to have you call in. And in the meantime, we're going to get you to do something else. Sweet. Okay. What's your next song that you have ready to go?
I think I'm going to do another song that I wrote called Hand on My Leg.
Hands on My Leg.
Hand on My Leg.
That's kind of interesting. Is that on one of these?
That's not. It's newer.
It's newer?
Yes.
Okay. So anyway, well, let's hear what you got there, and we'll talk about that then.
Sure. Sounds good. It was a Friday, how warm, I wanna see a ghost. And listen, she's a keeper, and you just smile. I made you laugh, and I didn't have to try. The sun got in her eyes, we cruised down 95, and you didn't miss a beat. You said, I like the way you think. So is this a one-time thing, or will I see you again? I said, come on, honey. Love is in a crime, but I'd be glad to do my time with you. With you, with you, with you. What we've got is new. On the road and your hand on my leg. You apologize for picking me up in your 1985 Ford like it was out of style. That's when I said, truth be told, I like the way you roll. It's got a wild soul, like somebody else in there. Yeah, come on, honey. Love is in a crime, but I'd be glad to do my time with you. With you, with you, with you. What we've got is new. Johnny Cash, Crosby, Stills, and Nash. I said, what are you trying to do? Made me fall in love with you. Come on. Love is in a crime, but I'd be glad to do my time with you.
Nice. Nice. Worked in Johnny Cash and Crosby, Stills, and Nash, huh? That's good. That's real good. That's pretty creative stuff.
Thank you.
Let's talk about this guitar a little bit, can we?
Of course.
How did you manage to get that beautiful Martin guitar?
Well, actually, a couple of years ago, maybe more like 3 years, because I do live streaming shows, which means that I go on a site called younow.com, and almost daily I broadcast just from my room, and people from all over the world get a chance to watch and chat and request songs. So one of my viewers who had been watching for a long time asked if they could get me a guitar. And they actually just sent the money in and said, you know, get which guitar you want. And I wanted to get a Martin, so that's what I got.
That's a beautiful Martin you got there.
It's beautiful, yes.
This has a three-piece back on it. It's a D35.
That's right.
And I see it's all wired for sound and everything, mm-hmm. too, huh? That's great.
It is.
That is beautiful.
Thank you.
So somebody that really appreciates your music and what you do bought you that guitar.
Yes.
And where are they from?
I think so. I don't know the exact state, but somewhere in the West Coast.
Somewhere on the West Coast. That is an incredible story.
It is incredible. Very lucky.
By the way, anybody out there wants to buy me a guitar? I'm just kidding. I got more than I need anyway. Yeah, that is a great story. So we were talking a little bit out here, and you also perform pretty regular.
Mm-hmm.
Whereabouts could people come and see you? To see you do something regular.
Yeah, well, this summer, actually, every month until late fall, I will be at Jake's Flea Market, which is an outdoor flea market in Bally, Pennsylvania. And there's a stage there, and I perform there. I don't know the exact dates by heart, but if you go to my website, there's a tour schedule there so people can see. But I'll be there once a month, every month.
Antique flea market, huh?
Yeah, it's really cool. It's a really big, so you can get some goodies, too.
I never been to that one, but I'm going to have
like
to stop
it.
Down there.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I like antiques. Can't afford them, but I like them.
Yeah.
I'm actually in the antique category myself now.
Oh,
yeah. I'm an antique. So maybe I could go down there. I don't know. Maybe somebody buy me. Who
maybe.
Knows? Yeah. All right. I got a couple things I want to take care of here real quick before we get another song out of you. First of all, I want to talk a little bit more about the Muhlenberg River Fest. That's going to be a two-day event, just like it says there, August 27th and 28th. We're going to have three stages out there. One's going to be the main stage with all the bands, and then we're going to have an acoustic stage down by the... Everything's down by the river, the beautiful Schuylkill River. And I'm telling you that we've been blessed. Muhlenberg Township has been blessed with one of the most scenic areas of the Schuylkill River, period. On the whole Schuylkill River... I mean, it's just gorgeous right there. So we're going to have three stages all day Saturday from 10 a.m. to 10 p.m. Then we're going to have a horseshoe contest competition. And this is one of the other things we're going to have right here that I wanted to talk about. And if you would zoom in on that flyer for me there, Sam, that is Heroes for Heroes. And we just had... This organization stopped by the office this morning. We had our committee, and they are going to be there doing a best dressed dog contest at our dog park. We have a beautiful dog park out there in Muhlenberg, and it's well used, and this is going to be on the 27th, Saturday the 27th. You'll be able to get more information on the website about it. So it's a Hero's Hero, and the Cat Works is going to oversee that. And here's something, let me get rid of this one, that's near and dear to me. And we know it's going to be near and dear to a lot of you folks that are especially veterans. We're going to have the moving wall come to Berks County to our Jim Dietrich Park. Right there it is, the moving wall, Vietnam Veterans Memorial Wall, June 9th through June 13th. And this is going to be quite an event. I know that there's going to be veterans there doing I don't know if they're actually doing reenactment, but there'll be a lot of Vietnam veterans there. Unfortunately, during the Vietnam War, when guys came back from there, they weren't treated like the folks are today. And it's about doggone time that they get honored. I happen to be in also 72, 74, and I understand that some bad things happen over there, and in any event, it's time that we recognize the folks that were doing the same job as everybody that ever wore the uniforms. One more thing here for me, Sam, please. This is coming up June. I got to read it backwards as soon as Sam gets that puppy on there. Will you please? There we are, June 11th. Is the Early Bird Fiddle Festival. And they got a great lineup. I'm going to pick this up so they can catch the lineup a little bit. They got a great lineup there on a stage. And in addition to that, I'm going to be out there with the guitars. You guys want to learn how to play guitars, you come on out and I'll show you how. And since we're in May, and then there's June, and then there's July, and that's how quick this summer's coming. And of course, that's the Kutztown Folk Festival. We want to make sure you come up there. There again, if you don't get a chance to come out to the Early Bird Fiddle Festival, you want to learn how to play guitar. That is July 2nd through the 10th. This is one of the top 10 festivals in the country. There I am right there. And I come up and show you how to play one of those guitars. So that's Kutztown Folk Festival. That's it for us right now. Now, let's get back to Naelee. I'm sorry. Say something. Oh, Naelee, I'm hearing voices. There they are again. What are you going to do for us next, kiddo?
Oh, I think I'm going to do a Fleetwood Mac song.
Okay.
My favorite one.
Okay.
This is Landslide.
Okay.
Okay. Take this love, take it down. Climb a mountain, you turn around. If you see my reflection in the snow-covered hills, a landslide will bring me down. Hold a mirror in the sky, what is love? Can the child within my heart rise above? Can I sail through the changing ocean tides? Can I handle the seasons of my life? Changing, cause I've been my life around you. But time makes you bolder, even children get older, and I'm getting older too. So
that was pretty.
Thank you.
I was sitting here thinking to myself, you know, Fleetwood Mac would have did that song. They that good. They might have had a hit.
Thank you.
That was very pretty. Who are your influences there, Naelee?
I mean, my favorite decades of music are probably the 60s and the 70s, although I do like a lot of the 80s as well, and some new artists. But I would say the Beatles are a huge influence in Fleetwood Mac, and James Taylor, and Joni Mitchell, and Carole King, and also like Michael Jackson, and Stevie Wonder, and the Doobie Brothers. It kind of ranges all over.
Yeah, I'd say that's a pretty good range, all right. Yeah, that's good. That's good. Well, so that's who you'd be listening on to on the radio if you're not playing.
Absolutely, yeah. I always have the classic rock station on.
Are they?
Yeah.
Good girl. Yeah, it doesn't get much better than the 60s and 70s as far as I'm concerned.
I don't think so.
Yeah. So, all right. So, you've been doing this since you're 14. You've been playing and writing songs. And you played at the Apollo and Madison Square Garden and stuff like that. Where would you like to be in about 5 years?
Where would I like to be in 5 years? I always struggle with questions like these purely because what I want now, maybe a different path will open up and maybe it won't be what I'm expecting or what I'm hoping for. Maybe it'll be better. But I'd like to still be doing this, obviously, and be doing it successfully and writing songs and hopefully playing bigger places. I'd love to have a full album recorded. And yeah, just I hope that wherever I am in 5 years, I feel settled and happy and content.
There you
and
go.
Still doing what I love to do.
You plan to do any further education?
Any what, sorry?
College or what, anything?
Oh, no. I was homeschooled, and I finished early so that I could focus on my music full time.
So you were homeschooled, so you learned something.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So who was your teacher?
Oh, my parents were.
Okay, your mom was your teacher, dad was principal?
Yes. Something like that.
I got a question there. I often wondered about homeschoolers. If you got in trouble like I did when in school, they couldn't send you home. Did they send you to school?
No, but that's a good question. But no, it didn't really work like that.
Okay. I'm just checking. Yeah. Well, dang, nabbit. Drop Vic under here. Come on, boy. All right. Well, as I told you, I'm going to do a little something just to break it up, okay? You ever see the movie Toy Story?
Yes.
Did you? Well, I got this great-grandson. He's about to be 7 years old come June, next month. And this is his favorite song. And he's got one of those Sheriff Woody dolls with a string on the back.
Oh, yeah.
Okay? And when he was about 4 or 5, he started getting pretty rough with this doll. And it's a little figure that looks like Sheriff Woody. Because it's kind of material. And I didn't want him pulling the legs and the arms off and stuff and ruining the thing. So I sort of kind of took it and put it up on my bookshelf so it would be preserved for when he gets a little older and appreciates it more. In any event, that stinking thing, believe it or not, you're sitting there and he's not around for a month or so to play with it. And after a while, this thing will start talking all by itself, just like it does in the movie. And this thing says, "There's a snake in my boot." Right in the middle of the night when you're sleeping, you hear this talk out in the living room, and what the heck is going on? So, anyway, this is a song. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old pal said. Boy, you got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got troubles, I got them too. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. A
we'll stick together and we'll see it through. Boy, you got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me. Some other folks may be a little bit smarter than I am, bigger and stronger too. Well, maybe. But none of them could ever love you the way I do. It's me and you, boy. And as years go by, our friendship will never die. You're gonna see that it's our destiny. You got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me. You got a friend in me.
Yay, I love that.
Hey, I like you. Anyway, that's the only song I can remember the words to. So, how many songs do you think you wrote?
Somewhere around 200. I don't know the exact number.
Really?
Yes, yeah, somewhere around
Wow. It's neat to... I try to explain songwriting to folks a lot of times like... Okay, thank you. Like kind of painting a picture, isn't it? With words.
It is. Absolutely.
And you got a great imagination. You got to write some really good songs. So anyway... You seen that lady hold that sign up?
I did, yes.
Okay, well, here's the situation. We got 10 minutes left on the air, I understand. Mm-hmm. And if we don't finish in 10 minutes, she's going to throw something at us.
That's something hard?
That's her job, yeah. Oh. Probably. One of them microphones or something. In any event, we have a few minutes left. I'm sure we can get a couple more songs. What would you like to do next?
I think I'm going to do a song that I wrote called Rolling Stone. And I'm going to do that next.
Rolling Stone.
Rolling Stone.
Okay.
That's it.
All right, kiddo.
Some lady named Teresa read your palm and Santa Fe. Said your soul was old, your future gold, then asked to be paid. Well, I could have told you that, 'cause I've held your hand before. Those who say hands don't do talking haven't held a hand like yours. Joined me to the desert, said I'm not a holy man, but you'll swear that you've seen heaven when the sun touches the sand. I don't go to church often, 'cause I don't feel Jesus there, but I've been to a rock concert and it sounded like a prayer. Ooh. You're gonna be a rolling stone. I won't let you be a rolling stone alone. You threw pennies at my feet, told me I'm your wishing well. Then we drove on down the highway, singing what a shade of pale. When I can't be with you, call me on the telephone. Somewhere in a cheap motel, you say, won't you come on home? Be defined, maybe that's true, but every every Johnny Mitchell song sounds like it's about you. And this one is too. If you're gonna be a rolling stone, I won't let you be a rolling stone alone.
All right, very nice.
Thank you.
Very nice. You know, there was one other thing I wanted to tell you folks at home, and that is, and I forgot my doggone, so I don't have it with me. Anyway, we're going to be out at the World War II weekend at the Reading Airport the first weekend in June. And I say we, I'm the guitar player with the Martin Sisters Band. We're going to be out there doing all 3 days, four shows a day. So there ain't no reason why you can't come out and see us. And we're going to be doing a lot of the songs from that era, back in the wartime years and what have you. And we're doing, what do you call, swing music, Texas swing music. So that's the three Martin sisters, Melissa, Emily, and Christy. And my identical twin brother, Mr. Eric Beans Fisher, is going to be on a doghouse bass. So we hope you get a chance to stop out and say hi. So I believe we might have a few minutes left. What would you like to do one more for the road?
Oh, I'd love to do one more.
Would you?
Sure.
I was taking notice. You use a flat pick, and you're doing finger picking, and you're strumming, and you're all kinds of techniques here.
Yeah.
Who taught you how to play this thing?
I taught myself how to play guitar.
Did you really?
I did, yes.
I am not surprised. Folks, there it is. Time and time again, you've seen folks on a road show, and they teach themselves how to play guitars. This isn't rocket science, but this is about dedication and experimenting, and hey, what does this sound like, and how does this feel, and so that's what kind of teaching yourself music is all about.
Definitely.
So you do a good job with it.
Thank you.
So what are you going to do next?
I think I'll end with another song that I wrote. This one's a bit of an older one, but it's called More For You.
So this is a classic.
Yes.
Okay, More For You?
Tita, More For You,
More
yeah.
For You, okay. Once again, now we got time yet to say goodbye. Go ahead and let that go.
Okay.
Something in you is changing, I can see it in your eyes. I try to ask, but you won't tell me. You just say everything's fine. You're fighting me like crazy. When did this become a war? Somewhere down the line, you forgot what we're in this for. Your heart's against my shoulder, and I can feel it breaking. I whisper to you, love's a choice, and it's something you're not making. You say I love you, at least I try to. And I swear that if I'm lying, then the sky ain't blue. And now I'm caving in, hard to understand. But when you look at me like that, I can breathe again. I'm doing the best that I can do, but I'll do even more. You. I swim where you are, so closer. Maybe then you feel like your scars are healing over. There's so much I can say, but the words don't wanna come. I'll say goodbye. I'm scared you'll just run away. Let's just say I love you. At least I tried to. And I swear if I'm lying in the sky ain't blue. I know I'm caving in. Hard to understand. But when you look at me like that, I can breathe again. I'm doing the best that I can do, but I'll do even more for you. And then I feel your arms, they pull me against you. I still feel a spark. I hope you feel it too. I hope you do. Because I love you. At least I try to. And I swear if I'm lying, then the sky ain't blue. And now I'm caving in. Hard to understand. When you look at me like that, I can breathe again. I'm doing the best that I can do, but I'll do even more for you.
Keep doing that chord there.
Keep playing soft. All right, we're going to have to go. The lady hung up to get the heck out of here sign. In any event, I'd like to thank our special guest, Miss Naelee Rae, this evening. Beautiful young lady, singer, songwriter. And be sure to go see her at Jake's, right?
That's
Jake's
right,
down on 100 in Bally. I know I'm going to head down there and check out the antiques. Hope to see you out and about. And until we see each other again, good night and God bless everybody. Go ahead and keep playing that there, G,
right.
And vamp a little bit and give them a little gone away music. Bye-bye.
BCTV receives state arts funding support through a grant from the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts, a state agency. Funded by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the National Endowment for the Arts, a federal agency.